expenditure. Makwetu says that though there's been a slight improvement in audit outcomes, a higher margin of improved results could have been recorded if leadership had stepped up the pace in addressing internal control deficiencies identified in the previous audit. Let's chat to Kimi Makwetu, the South Africa's Auditor General. Good to have you in studio. Welcome.
Good morning, Leon.
Let's start off with good news, shall we? Let's talk about the increase in the municipalities showing a clean audit. It was 13, and it's really gone much better. It's gone up to 54. So are you happy with that at least?
Well, I mean, if you look at the beginning of the current term of local government, 2010-2011, that number of clean audits was a mere 13, which represented 5% of the total. At least, I think, if we look at where we are now, sitting at 54, plus an additional 18 public entities, the likes of Johannesburg Water and all of those, takes the number to 72 in total. I think it's a significant improvement that needs to be recognized.
Yeah, but there's still a huge concern, though, because it's saying that 92% of the country's 278 municipalities is either of concern or interventions are required. So we're nowhere near out of the woods as yet.
And the area that we are paying attention to in that report, Lied, is the financial health risk that is now confronting municipalities. Because there are a number of instances where you see this municipality in terms of the revenue it's generating. Yeah. If it's earning 50 and it's continuing to spend 120, we all know what is likely to be the outcome of that. These controls that we are highlighting are not just your nice to have disciplines of internal control. They are about trying to narrow that gap so that they can at least have an opportunity to continue to survive financially.
Yeah. I mean, one of the things you did say yesterday when you were delivering the report is that we are seeing that municipalities are now giving better reporting, so their reporting is good, but the financial management is bad. Which, I mean, the financial management is what's key here, isn't it?
Well, the financial management at the core, if you look at the three elements that we are evaluating in our analysis, the three elements that make up a clean audit. The first one is the financial management, which I think is improving in terms of reporting on financial statements. When it comes to reporting on their performance, they are doing better than where they were 5 years ago. But the biggest disappointing area is the compliance with legislation. That's where the likes of your supply chain management, which give rise to irregular expenditure, which gives rise to the likes of your fruitless and wasteful expenditure, is largely concentrated, including unauthorized expenditure. So while you are saying that the attempt to put in the debits and the credits in the right place and be reasonable to change whatever it is that you've done wrong, we are concerned that the rules of the game are not observed, and that's what's causing the risk of financial loss into the future.
Yeah. I want to talk about the consultants, because that was just crazy. When you look at it, 3 billion rand spent on consultants. I mean, surely this can be cut back on the amount of consultants that are being used and paid.
And as long as we appreciate that amount is with regards to this whole 5 years, but the 1 year component of that for 2014-15 is 892 million across all 272 of them.
Yeah.
We even think there in terms of the annual spend, that can also be brought down, because if you look at what happens after the money has been spent, if a municipality is able to spend somewhere close to 10 million rands a year on financial management services, and it still ends up with a generally lousy outcome in terms of the audit results, then I think the question should be, what is the value of that expenditure if it is not going to translate into something better? Because what it means is that you are going to continue making that expenditure into the future if somebody doesn't take steps to correct it.
I mean, the question that needs to be asked is, I mean, can we not get capable personnel to actually do this in-house? Why does it have to be outsourced?
Well, that's exactly the point that we are highlighting to those that are charged with governance. I think the question you're asking is exactly what we have been raising all along.
Yeah. It needs to be done. Fill those vacancies with competent people. Let's break it down, because we've been showing a few of the different provinces and how they've been doing. So let's talk about our top performing provinces and how they're doing.
We've noted in our report that the Western Cape is one of them, certainly leading the rest. Gauteng and KwaZulu-Natal are the other two that have also performed admirably over this five-year period.
Yeah.
There are signs of excellence in many of them. If you look at Ekurhuleni, this is the second year that Ekurhuleni is recording a clean audit together with a number of entities within its fold. The same goes for the city of Cape Town. And we've noted that even in other municipalities at a local level, there are those that have done very well in the Eastern Cape, like Joe Kabi District Municipality, among many. So there's many elements of it, but I think it's good to acknowledge those three as the leading provinces, with the Western Cape showing a good 10 of 73% in total of their municipalities being clean.
But what can we learn from them? I mean, what are they doing in order to achieve this?
Leanne, there's a quarterly engagement that takes place, which is presided over by the Premier in that province, where all the mayors and the MECs responsible for this area of local government gather together with the municipal managers. Among other things, they look at the audit action plan diligently, where reports are given and specific steps are taken to make sure that the next quarter they are not dealing with the same issues that arose in the previous quarter. That's the kind of leadership focus that we see coming through in other areas as well. But they've done it diligently for the last 4 or 5 years. And we've been in those meetings physically as the auditors on a quarterly basis to evaluate whether they are doing the right things. And they have taken the decisions themselves to bring people with the right skills, as well as to do the necessary to keep their accounting records, because auditors are only relying on their accounting records to come to their conclusion. Yeah. In the absence of that, and in the absence of anyone doing that work technically correct, then the audit conclusion will not change.
All right. Let's take a very quick break, because when we return, we're going to talk about those provinces that didn't do well. I mean, in fact, some of them not getting anywhere, not even showing one clean audit. But that's something we'll talk about after the break, with the municipal elections just around the corner. What does a report like this actually do to the voters' decisions as well? Stay tuned. We have this after the break.